Hey, everybody. My name is Miss Kayla, and I want to welcome you to After Sunday, where we go out and about with our favorite gospel artists to share their lives, ministry, music, and testimony. Our show is packed with fun, fellowship, and even acting sketches. Today, we're going out and about with Grammy nominated, multiple Stella Award winner, and my friend, Tye Tribbett. So guess what? We're going out and about, and you're coming with me. After the preacher stops preaching, and the choir stops singing, and the doors of the church are closed, get to know the real person after Sunday.
4, 3, 2.
Let's go!
High energy, impactful, fun, creative, and out of this world anointed, all express the musical genius and ministry of Tye Tribbett. Long before the airwaves played No Way, Victory, and Stand Out, Tye Tribbett and his New Jersey youthful community choir, Greater Anointing, sang up and down and around the East Coast, ministering to all who would listen, allowing him to grace the stage with such greats as Gloria Estefan, Leanne Rimes, Luther Vandross, Jill Scott, Stevie Wonder, Kirk Franklin, Mary Mary, and many of today's gospel greats. And really, that's just naming a few. This Camden, New Jersey homeboy is a husband, father of two, gospel singer, songwriter, producer, and minister. He has never left his roots, remembering that family is the anchor that keeps him grounded, and the gospel of Jesus Christ is what keeps him pressing on. Today, Tye Tribbett not only creates music for God, but he shares the gospel weekly through his phenomenal Bible study, Word on the Street, teaching kingdom principles, My Life, His Way. Come and join us as we meet the man behind the ministry, energy, and the anointing. Tye Tribbett, After Sunday.
Know all about you growing up, like what it was like as a kid. I know the Tribbett house had to be crazy.
Just don't ask my mom nothing.
Oh, I will. I cannot wait. She already signed up as on board to talk to us. So like I cannot wait to talk
don't
to
them.
I talked to your kids already. Wait till you see what they say. I talked to your best friend, Isaac Carree. Wait
no!
to hear his stories. I remember. They answer, I remember when Ty.
No!
I remember when we were in L.A. And this is how close we are. Mm-hmm. Me and my wife, Teddy and Tina, which is Tina from Mary Mary, mm-hmm. Warren and Erica, the other girl from Mary Mary, we were having this little couples thing at Teddy and Tina's house. And we all had like a little slumber party. We had fun, we hung out. So that morning, Tina got up and cooked everybody breakfast. And so Ty, everybody in the living room, we chilling, getting ready. Ty, Shante, they getting ready. Top bus out the road with some boots on and his drawers and running around the whole house. And when I tell you, we laughed and cried until we just couldn't take it no more. He has to be one of the funniest persons I've ever met in my whole life.
I want to talk to the heart of Ty. I want people to know about you as a human being. So that's what this is all about after Sunday.
Right.
I want to know what life is like for you after Sunday.
Tired, nap time, take a break, go eat. I'm always tired from what we do in church. And I love the title of the show because my whole life has been centered around Sunday and not after Sunday. So, you know, my dad was a pastor, everybody knew my mom. So that's all we knew. I just met my dad after I left his church.
Really?
I'm just saying, like, he was a pastor to me.
You met him as a person?
Yeah. Uh-huh. So, you know, We're starting to build a real relationship at this point really late because church consumed our lives. But who I am as a person, I'm a goofy young man who love to have fun with his kids and his wife.
And what's your favorite thing to do with that? Ah, what do you play?
different games. Like, one person's a joker and he tries to make us laugh, it can really make us sick.
He likes to laugh. I've seen him do some silly things sometimes, but he makes me laugh too. What about you, Lincoln?
He's loud, and I don't think that's all I know.
Are you loud?
Yes.
You can be loud like Daddy.
We do the stupidest stuff, goofy, and just have fun. But then, I'm just a man. I'm just a regular person. You know, everybody sees Superman, but I'm just Clark. I'm just Clark Kent.
What do you think people should know about Tye Tribbett that they wouldn't normally know or normally see from just meeting him?
He's human. I mean, just that. He's human. I mean, don't get me wrong. Don't cut nobody no slack. But just know he human. I mean, he think like we think like everybody else think. Because a lot of people get that, you know, mixed up. They see a gospel artist. They think, put him on a pedestal and stuff like that. He human. He sleep like we sleep. He need rest like we need. I mean, he sin like we sin. Like, I mean, like, any forgiveness, all that. I mean, he's human.
The more people talk to me and get to know me, the more similar we find ourselves being. You know what I mean? God just chose to shine a light on certain people in certain seasons. But everybody's the same in his eyes to me.
Let your light so shine before men, so that they may see your good works and glorify your Father in heaven. Matthew 5:16. I hope you're enjoying After Sunday. I want you to stay right here, because we're coming back with some funny stories all about Tye Tribbett growing up. And guess who's going to share them with us? That's right, his mama. You know we did. So stay right here on After Sunday. Hey. Welcome back to After Sunday with gospel music sensation Tye Tribbett. You ever wonder what somebody famous was like when they were a kid? I mean, did they get into trouble? Were they well behaved? Did they climb into the choir stands looking for loose change, but find a pen? Well, we're gonna talk to Miss Neicy T, Tye Tribbett's mama, and find out. I wonder what she got to say.
Now, Tye Tribbett is your second child?
Yes.
Okay. So, we want to know, what kind of things, what did he do to spend with his time on his own? Like, how did he spend his time by himself? What kind of things would he do?
Well, basically, he was hardly ever by himself. Mm-hmm. Because of the fact that he's such an outgoing person. And if it wasn't him and his brother, it would be him and his other friends.
I remember when Tye threw his own, I think it was 18th birthday party, and we had about 200 people in and out of our house.
Having four kids, you can't do big birthdays for all of them. You try to, about, you know, put them all together. He kept going around and said, "Mom, have a big party, Mom, get it ready. You know, I'm like, okay, you know, yeah, right, okay, you know. We started getting calls from New York, Ohio. Folk were coming to this party at my house. He planned his own party by word of mouth, you know? So he was never, I would say, was never alone. Only in the bathroom. Don't tell me alone.
Only alone time.
He was always with someone.
What was something that Tye had to do in order to play outside? Things he had to do.
Tye had everybody in the family had either a week to do the dishes or a particular day. Tye would always get out of doing his week doing the dishes. He always would have his sister. I don't know how he did it. When I would come home, you know, I see the Maris at the sink.
What you doing?
Leave me alone. I got work to do.
Tye, you better do them dishes, boy.
Damaris, come here. I need to talk to you about something.
What you want? I'm not doing your dishes.
No. It's about my music.
Daddy. to music?
I need to work on this new music so I can start the group.
And what does that have to do with me?
You know you're gonna be the first member of the group.
Really? What do I need to do?
I need to go down in the garage and work on this music, so I need you to do these dishes.
Uh-uh, Ty, you think you slick. I'm a tall mom.
Shut up, mommy.
Ty, I know you ain't playing with me. You better get them dishes done. Boy, you better do them dishes for I'll send you outside to pick your switch, and you better not bring me no little one either. You hear what I'm saying? Now, whatever you doing in here, you better stop. And leave your sister alone, or you know what's gonna happen to you.
Okay, Mom.
Okay.
If you do these dishes, I'll let you sing lead in one of the songs.
You better not be lying to me, Ty.
Come on, we're gonna travel the world.
All right, I'll do it this time. But you have to let me listen to my song when it's finished.
Okay, I got you.
That's just a little taste of what it was like when it was time to make music in the Tye Tribbett house. I want you to stay right there, because we're coming back with our After Sunday family. We're going to ask them their favorite Tye Tribbett song. And you definitely want to hear what she has to say. So don't you go nowhere. Welcome back to After Sunday with my friend Tye Tribbett. It's time to find out some of our favorite Tye Tribbett songs. And we're gonna ask our After Sunday family. Come on.
My favorite song is Everything. Because God is everything to me. And when I get down and feel a little needy, I gotta remind myself.
What's yours?
I got the victory.
You got the victory. Is that, what's yours, Miss Maddie?
I got the victory. I love that song.
My favorite Tye Tribbett song is If He Did It Before, He Could Do It Again. One, two, one, two, three. And he starts to sing it. Yes, and it just makes me go like, oh man. And I be in my house, I'm doing my exercise sometimes. And then we get to the screaming part, I start screaming. My sister say, could you hold it down? If he did it before, he could do it again. Ow!
Mentorship is wisdom without the pain. So I wasn't mentored, so I had to get wise through pain, you know, unfortunately. So a lot of mistakes I made helped shape the character. Besides that, you know my mom, she don't play. My grandma don't play, my grandparents. I grew up in the switch days. I go outside and pick what switch you're gonna get beat with. Now that's some psychological trauma right there.
What's
wrong with you? I'm trying to pick the smaller, I'm like, that's gonna hurt. The big one, that's gonna hurt.
He talks to us about having to pick his switch. So can you talk a little bit about
and
that?
He would always pick the weakest switch.
Of course, of course.
He picked so many switches, the tree is bare.
So so I got bees growing up.
Miss Neicy beat you?
Yes! Yes, Miss Neicy beat me and she ain't care.
Him and his brother stayed in trouble. I am amazed that he graduated. Because it wasn't bad trouble. You know, it wasn't evil, it wasn't wicked. It's just always keeping people laughing, you know, not taking your work seriously in school, even keeping the teachers laughing. I think they promoted him because they liked him. He had such a charisma. They didn't want to hold him, they just love him. Oh, they just, oh, Thomas, he's just so sweet, but he just talks too much. I can't get any work done. I can't teach because he had the class laughing. So he, you know, they just promoted him.
So he was a class clown.
Class clown.
That shaped me, of course, then when I got married, very young age, 21. When I got married then.
What?
Yeah, I was 21, my wife was 18.
Oh, I ain't know nothing about, like, I was nowhere near.
Yeah, you was out there partying and all that. Exactly. Lord, just forgive her for everything she does. Sweet Jesus' name. Anyway, we got married very, very young after the rhythmics competition. Well, anyway, that's another story. So, my wife is so responsible for the man that y'all see now.
If you were to answer Tye Tribbett is, what would your answer be?
I would say Tye Tribbett is strong. He's a very strong man. naturally and spiritually, I think that he's definitely the pillar of our family, as being a provider, as being the man of God, the man in the house, as being fun, being, he doesn't stress a lot, so I just see strong in him, personally, from my point of view.
Strong.
She just shaped me, you know, as a woman, as a wife. Right. Y'all sometimes gotta help. Help!
I know.
Help me! Amen! Help mold us, because we still, you know, putting away childish things, and we still, whatever. She, I mean, even to the music, like, she liked a certain kind of music at that time. I was like, well, let me try to write something like that. And, you know, I wrote a lot of, for people who know, songs in major keys. She liked minor, dark, you know, darker stuff. So I started writing that way, and one of the most known songs I wrote is a minor song, Victory.
Yeah.
It's minor. So, but anyway, but she helped shape every part of me, the man, the husband, the, you know, she was very patient with me. But she didn't know, it wasn't like, we were sitting down, like, listen, you wake up. It wasn't like that, but just through her love and through our relationship.
Amen.
She shaped my character the most.
What was an average Saturday like in the Tribbett household?
Well, it was always filled with music, of course, either preparing for a rehearsal. My parents would, you know, they were the musicians and music leaders of the church and also our organization. So either preparing for music or just us running around and doing nothing. But we always had music in the house.
Now, I remember the very first time that I learned he had talent was that he was in the kindergarten and they had a Valentine's Day show. And so everybody was to do their talent. So he said, Mom, I'm going to play. I'm like, you're going to play? He said, yeah. So we had a little keyboard about that big. And I went to the, you know, for the little program in the classroom. And he played, I Just Called to Say I Love You, and tears. I was like, oh my God, this boy's talented.
In the garage is where he kind of was inspired to do the music and writing, him and my brother. So they always had musicians coming in and out of the house and keeping us up 3 o'clock in the morning.
He played by ear, you know, and all the instructor had to do was play it one time. And he was like, okay, I'm gonna do my own thing. And then when the instructor came to the next week, he just played what he heard him play, but he did not read the music. He was just playing by ear. And I said, I'm wasting money, because he wanted to do da-da-da-da-da-da-da. You know, he wanted to do church music. They're doing Bach. He ain't into that. He wants to just, you know, because his father is an organist. And my brother is a professor. He teaches music. So there's music on both sides of the family. So it was just in him. So to be able to try to teach him was not, you can't teach a gifted person. They have to learn on their own. To watch him perform, it's never the same thing. He always bring in a different element. He always allowed the Lord to use him in a different way.
If you can't sing, you don't sit by the wrong person.
Like, if you listen to gospel music before time, then after time, like, people got hits in these songs now. And like, Shawn breaks be all crazy now. Like, it's just a groundbreaking gospel music. Like, that movement that he said, you know, even with all the GA and everybody, and sound check and everybody, like, even with them, like, they, like, it was tied, you know what I mean? Like, they just broke a lot of ground and got some music. He's a groundbreaker.
Number one, we gotta have more.
Tie Tribbett to you.
Who is Tye Tribbett, or who is Thomas Tribbett?
Who is
my first name is Thomas.
Okay.
Tye Tribbett.
Thomas Tyrone Tribbett?
Yes.
Who is Thomas Tribbett?
Thomas Tribbett is, I just realized that I'm a very low-key person. Mm-hmm. When I'm home or when I'm settling, I'm very low-key. My family and I, we always still have fun. But I'm admitting it to the whole world. I'm not as engaging as I thought with people. I'm not as much of a people person as I thought I was. As much, I didn't say I'm not, but as much of one as I thought. Because with Tye Tribbett, and I hate to talk schizophrenic like that, but I have to make sure that my good is not even spoken of, that I'm like, hey, okay, all right. And that's me too. Mm-hmm. But when I crash, I'm like, oh, people be walk, like, my wife tell me, like, you didn't even speak to the waitress sometimes. Like, hey, sir, can I take your order? I'm like, I just crash sometimes, but I think it's because of an overload.
Yeah.
But I
and
think
you happen to be so up. Yeah. Like this Tye Tribbett, you know, that we see. You're like, hey, how you doing?
Yeah. Like, I'll be trying, like, for shows and stuff, like, to be like, so other different shows. Like, hey, can I do a Holding On? Can I do Chasing After You? Slow. I want to present another side of me. Mm-hmm. Come on, man. We need that energy. We need it, huh? And I understand. I'm grateful for the brand on the business side. I'm grateful for the brand. I'm grateful for to have my own lane, so to speak, in the industry. I'm grateful. However, it's so much to always have to give that, even when you don't feel like it. You know what I mean?
And a lot of people don't know he'd be tired. Half like a lot of gigs, he'd be tired.
It's a hectic schedule.
Yeah, he'd be tired. I mean, but you go on the stage, you get like this boost of energy. Like, it's crazy. It's like just being back there, but like he is tired. And we get out there, he gets. That's just God in his life, man. He's a really anointed. He's just anointed dude.
He's a father. He's a son. He's a husband. So he needs time to be those things as well. So I try to bring balance to it and know when to do and when not to do, because you know, his time is valuable. So I try to just fill out and try to balance everything.
When I'm by myself a lot of times, or when I'm home, I'm like, we watching HGTV, we chilling. I mean, my kids is all over the place and we have fun and I love people. I hope nobody take that the wrong way, what I said. Mm-hmm. But you know, it's just—
You're human.
Yeah.
Like, we all like our downtime and just be able to be ourselves.
Yeah.
And that's so important. I get a chance to see another side of you come into Bible study, even especially when I witness the Lord using you.
Amen.
You know, and sometimes in the beginning of Bible study, you're showing us Tye Tribbett. And then right, at some point, God takes over and he talks to the man.
Mm. Hey, I want you to stay right here, because we're going to Word on the Street, Tye Tribbett's amazing Bible study. And I want you to come with me. So stay right there.
Mm-hmm. Hey everyone, welcome back to After Sunday. We're going out and about to Tye Tribbett's amazing Bible study, Word on the Street, in Camden, New Jersey.
I can't wait to go to Tye Tribbett's Bible study. Can you wait?
No.
So, come on, let's go.
Okay.
Well, I guess I better go with them. Ladies.
It's time. What has been your proudest moment of Tye as an adult?
Him delivering the word of God. He has such a revelation of the word, and it's amazing. We, the family, respect him so much, and we respect the gift that's in him. How this preaching mantle is on him, and it's just totally amazing what the Lord gives him out of a simple scripture.
We adjust our lives based on the winds, but the captain adjusts the ship based on the destination. And as he's on course, no matter what happens, he don't know how the winds are going to blow. No matter how the wind blows, he adjusts the whole ship based on his set course. So, you can be like, man, I'm going to be the head and not the tail. And life hits you, you'd be like, maybe not. Maybe I need to just go ahead and stay the tail. It's easier to be the tail. I don't care what hits your life. You stay on course. I don't care which way he knocked you. I'm just being on. Look at you there and say, I'm going somewhere. You just stay on. I don't care. Y'all put out of here. Let me go ahead and my wife.
Well, I know God is waiting on him. You know, God has already made the decision.
We're all waiting on him.
Yeah, me too. You know, and I think what he's doing on Wednesday nights is preparing him.
Yes, it is.
It's for him, mm-hmm. You know, so that he can, you know, see how it is to have the same congregation every week and have to break down a series, you know, each week. This is all training for him. And I love the way he's taking steps. I love the way he's not just jumping because somebody prophesied you're going to be a pastor and he just jumping in the pulpit and grabbing a briefcase. I love the way he is consulting the Lord and making sure that, you know, he is ready, you know, to walk worthy of the vocation wherewith he is called.
You know also that he's going to be a preacher.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we knew that growing up.
Really? Did he preach around the house?
He didn't preach, but he always could keep an audience, and he always had something good to say, you know. So he knew how to relate to people, and he could, his revelation of the word came later, but we knew that he would always have a presence and an audience for people.
Do you know that Ty is going to be a preacher?
Do I know? Uh-huh. Of course. Uh-huh. I know, yeah. And definitely.
How does that fit in with your lives? Like, how do you feel about that? You're going to be a first lady and Ty's going to be a preacher. Like, he's going to be. I know this. Mm-hmm. I see this. Mm-hmm. Like, it's undeniable.
I would love that. I love the idea. God called him to do it, and he flows in it, so I love it.
I just can't wait till he start the church.
Yeah, we know.
And he start taking in members. Amen. Because I'm telling you, me and my wife have been talking about relocating the whole time. We just want to sit under his word and sit under his ministry.
There's a calling on your life that I know you know. I talked to your wife about it. I talked to your mom about it. When did you hear that calling on your life, and when did you say yes to it?
The reason why I stalled at answering the call of pastorship or teaching or whatever, because when I first heard it was from people.
Okay.
Oh, God, you're a pastor. You just like, so I'm like, you know, I understand how they praise you, and then I understand that, so I didn't really take it seriously. But it wasn't until, I guess, a couple of years ago, you know, I always did Bible study with GA, but a couple of years ago, I really, like, kind of really just embraced it, like, okay, this is happening. And when I started realizing that the song and the word ministry was equal, and then it's like the word ministry is like more my heart than music. You know what I mean? So I never thought that would happen. You know, I would rather read than play sometimes. So when I started seeing that happen, I'm like, oh, this is serious. Like, when it started taking over my passions and my desires and, you know, just what I wanted to do, I said, this is serious. So I stopped running from it, and we started the word on the street.
Because you're going to be a pastor.
Oh, bless you. Bless you. The next question says.
For real.
I accept it. Yeah. I embrace it. And I'm not going to say I'm ready for it, but the Lord said it. So I just agree with what he said. And it's going to be easy.
Amazing.
His yoke is easy. So I'm just embracing that side of you know, the ministry.
That obedience.
Yeah.
And sometimes it's not. I know in my own life.
Come on,
like,
man.
He'll tell me to do something. And even in being obedient. Last week, talked about your GPS and your roadmap and staying. That was really important to me in my life, and even in this ministry that we're doing, because things are thrown at you.
Yes.
And you staying on course regardless of what happens to your life, and knowing that call that God has on your life is just so important. And just that week of this week alone, your word that God spoke to you spoke to me in my life and was important for my family.
Amen. We're amazed as well. Like, every time I'm like, can I get the CD? What God is saying, it's him. It is all him. And I'm like, wow. So, you know, I need it for my life as well. So what God is doing here is just amazing. So I'm grateful for the season, this time, and what it's doing for this area and my family and my marriage. Like, accepting this is really, you know what I mean, having a godly influence on every part of my life.
Thank you, Ty.
Did I
ask everything that was really important that I needed to know?
Yes.
Yes, I did. I did. So cool.
We did.
And we're going to go to Word on the Street now and be fed.
Word on the Street, let's do it. If you're ever around 3100 Westfield Avenue, Camden, New Jersey, come through and be fed. I guarantee it's a blessing here for you.
For real.
Yeah.
We really enjoyed Word on the Street with Minister Tye Tribbett.
We want to thank you for hanging out with us on After Sunday, where we go out and about with our favorite gospel artists to share their lives, ministry, music, and testimony. Until next time.
Wait, Mommy, wait. Milo and Seth, tell us how we get saved.
Oh, okay. Milo, you know what? Let's tell them. Go ahead.
Here's how you get saved. You confess the Lord as your Savior, and you believe that Jesus Christ died for your sins. Bye!
Bye.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Come on, ladies. Thank you. Jayla, come on.